Shalom Aleichem and welcome to Machin Leira Online Smicha. The fifth bracha in Shemayna Esrei, like every bracha in Shemayna Esrei, is loaded with very interesting, simple pshat. Obviously pshat, Remez, Drush, Soit, Shemayna Esrei is a special time. But I'm just going to touch upon two or three interesting nekudas about the fifth bracha, the bracha of Hashiveinu Avinu L'Eser Nesecha, where we ask Hashem to bring us back to His Torah, V'karveinu Malkeinu L'Avid Esecha, and bring us closer to serving Him, V'achazireinu B'Shuvah Shalem L'Fanecha. And we conclude with the bracha Baruch Atah Hashem, Haroitzeh B'Shuvah. So there's a few interesting points about this bracha. First of all, there's one part of the request we refer to the Eibishter as Avinu, our Father, Hashiveinu Avinu L'Eser Esecha. 1 second later, we come to Him and say, V'karveinu Malkeinu L'Avid Esecha. We ask Hashem to bring us closer, as referring to Him as our King. The second point is, this is going to be the first of a string of brachas where we refer to an item, Shlema, and we ask, we want it to be complete. We have the tshuva, it's brought in Svarim, that there are four things that we refer the word Shlema to. Tshuva Shlema, and then we know Geula Shlema, Tshuva Shlema, Geula Shlema, Refuah Shlema, and Ani Mamin, we say Ani Mamin Be'emuna Shlema. Those are the four things that we attach the word Shlema. We want a complete package. And there's a way to remember it. It's a Rosh Teva's Estrig. Esrig has to be complete. Esrig has to be Hadar. So Esrig is Aleph is Emuna Shlema, Tav is Tshuva Shlema, Resh is Refuah Shlema, and Gimel is the Geula Shlema. Just an interesting point. Let's just highlight some interesting thing that says in Halacha about this bracha in short. Number one, this bracha is number 5, and it goes right after the bracha of the first request of Ata Chayin La'odom Das. What's the connection, what's the flow, that once you ask for Das, you go for this bracha. The next one is Hashiveinu Avinu L'Eser Esecha, which is ultimately asking the Eibishter to bring us back, we should do tshuva. So it says in Svarim, because once you got Das, once you got Bina, you got wisdom, and you see a clear picture of what's going on in your life, obviously you see what's important, what's not important, and the first thing comes to your mind, I got to shape up, I got to do tshuva. So right after Bina comes the bracha of tshuva. The Kalbuy writes that in this bracha, there are 15 words. What's the connection? Why specifically this bracha 15 words? Says the Kalbuy, because there are Shiva Rakiyim, there are 7 worlds, and in between every one Rakiyah and the next Rakiyah, there's a space, Avir. So there are Shiva Rakiyim plus Shiva Avirim, and then the Kisa HaKavod is on top of all that. So we're asking that we should be brought back. As low, Rachmana Litzlan, as we were able to be fall, we want to go back the 15 levels all the way to as Shuvah's Magas, Ad Kisei HaKavod. And it also brought in Svarim that this is the bracha of Tshuva. And it says that the famous pasuk of Yazev Rasha Darkei Ve'ish Avim Machshavosov Vel Elikenu Hiyar B'Lisloach, the famous pasuk which speaks about a Yid doing tshuva, leaving his past ways, is also 15 words. There's a significance how the level of when a person does tshuva, he can go from the lowest of level all the way to the highest of high. The bracha begins with a hey, Hashiveinu Avinu L'Eser Esecha, and finishes off with a hey, Haroitzeh B'Tshuva. This too is important for the mitzvah of tshuva, because hey and hey is 5 + 5 = 10. This is referring to the 10 days of tshuva, the Aser Yisimei tshuva. That's Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur. Back to the original question, why do we begin by saying Avinu? Not always in davening we refer to the Eibishter as our Father. So the answer is like this. It's brought in Svarim. The Torah says that we're asking Hashem to bring us back to learning Torah. The first part is for Torah, and the Karveinu Malkeinu is for mitzvahs. So mitzvahs is more a commandment. Commandments, you refer to the Eibush as the melech. But for the Torah, there is a person falls away, God forbid, a person does the wrong thing, it's very difficult for him to come back. Because, you know, he rebelled, and it's a patch upon him to whoever he rebelled against. But a son, as far as Rachman al-Tlan, he may stray off the path, he will always be welcome back. And this is what we're saying. Hashiveinu avinu l'sarisecha v'istachfartun zotata. And because our father, we always have a part to this Torah, because every son gets the Yerusha, gets the inheritance, equal inheritance from the father. So every Yid has a part in the Torah. And there's another diuk. And the diuk is, al pi halacha, every father has to teach the son Torah. So we turn to the Eibishter and say, Eibishter, you are our father. If you are our father, it is your obligation to teach us Torah. And this is what we're asking you in this bracha. And this is, in general, the bracha of tshuva, the fifth bracha right after the bracha of das.